Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. Today we are going to see the various manufacturing processes of plastic products. In this video tutorial, we are going to cover rotational molding process. Now we are going to see the rotational molding process. In a rotational molding process, you can see in the image on the screen, a predetermined amount of polymer powder is loaded in the mold. The mold is heated while rotating on two perpendicular axes. Gravity is the acting force in this process, not the centrifugal force. This results in uniform thickness. Molds are simple and less expensive. Products, trash cans or bucket, hollow toys, Sintex tanks and plastic football can be made by this rotational molding process. In the image you can see the primary axis and the secondary axis, and it rotates about both the axes. You can see two axis rotations. We have already dumped the material and after that it is rotating about the first axis, then it is rotated about the second axis, so that finally we can get the output. You can see the final output on the screen. About the materials, mild steel molds or stainless steel molds, cast aluminium molds and the Teflon coated molds are used. These are the materials which used for the rotational molding process. The main design consideration of a rotational molding process, we have to focus the sharp corners and edges should be avoided as they create stress point or lines. Internal feature need to be adequately separated, that means at least 3 to 5 times the wall thickness of the part to allow the proper melt flow. The mostly rotational molding materials are polyethylene, that is PE, or polypropylene, PP, polyvinyl chloride, PVC, nylon and polycarbonate. These are the mostly materials we are using for the rotational molding process. Some of the times, that means occasionally, we can use also ABS, acetal, acrylic, epoxy, polyether, polyester and polystyrene. Main advantages of the rotational molding process is one piece product design reduces and eliminates the assembly cost. Second point about the advantages, that is the allows complex mold split lines. Third, allows molded, threaded and mold in inserts and very little waste in material. Low residual stresses. There are thermal stresses during the cooling process, but almost no forming stresses because no external pressure is ever applied on the rotational molding process. Tooling is less expensive. Due to its low pressure operation, the wall thickness of the molding chamber can be thinner than those for the other molding methods. Suitable for both low volume prototypes and high volume production runs also. The main disadvantage of rotational molding process is a slow production speed. It usually takes about 1 hour to finish a cycle, as opposed to the just a few seconds for the typical injection molding process, because it is used injection molding machines we are already seen it is used for the mass productions. And second one is the lower precision. Now we are going to see the compression molding process, a method of molding in which the molding material, generally preheated, is first placed in an open heated mold cavity. The mold is closed with a top force or plug member. Pressure is applied to the force, the material into contact with all mold areas, and heat and pressure are maintained until the molding material has curved. you can see in the image, the compression molding machine. Green color you can see, that is the charge, and lower fixed molding half. From the top you can see upper movable molding half, and it pressures and ejector pin is there for ejection purpose. And in this image you can see the red color, that material becomes compressed. You can see in the image how it looks practically, the compression molding process, for clear understanding. In compression molding also you can see that the natural fiber, or you can say the polypropylene material, is heated, and in the next image you can see it laminates and a substrate in mold. It is the TPO film cross-linked on it, and the natural fiber and PP substrate, and the two mold halves, one is the fixed and other one is the movable, you can see in the image. Once the mold closes and forms the material, and at final stage when mold becomes opened, formed parts is removed. You can get the clear understanding from this image, that is the TPO skin and the natural fiber and PP substrate at the bottom, in such a way that compression molding also work. For compression molding process we mostly prefer the materials like the polyester, polyamide, polypropylene sulfide, that is PPS, and fiber reinforced plastics. And the most of the applications of compression molding process is used for the hoods, fenders, scoops, spoilers, as well as the smaller, more intricate parts.